Hello and welcome back to my RP1 campaign on hard. So we've got a launch pad under construction. Still, we've got more science to invest. Pretty sure I can remove some old vessels now. That's interesting. I wonder why that was stopped. Why is this thing out of battery? Oh, I see. Okay, you can go away. Still running the orbital perturbation experiment, so we'll leave that. Okay. That's a little bit cleaned up. So we've got our crew building for a crew rotation mission. Okay, so its deadline is November. Okay, so we can send up our new crew in time for that. Okay. I'm gonna look up this contract because I'm not quite sure how it works. And that's dangerous. Okay, we need to. Okay, I think this will work. The thing that I was concerned about was this return crew home safely thing. Unclear whether it meant this crew or this first crew. If it meant the first crew, we would fail the deadline. I mean, I guess we wouldn't. It just would be a very short rotation. So I'll accept that. And in 10 days, we will bring our crew home. Here we go. Okay, well, we've very definitely been sweet. All right, it actually did preserve the duration record. 60-day duration record. Interesting that we're out of nitrogen. That's not great. All right, we'll have to send up a have to send up a nitrogen tanker, I guess. So many crew transfers. Wait a minute. Uh-oh, that's bugged. That's bad. It's because the IVA has 3 seats, even though the crew capacity is 5, I think is why that's bugged. Yes, there's 3 crew aboard. I try to transfer crew again. And we'll see if it fails. Yep. Okay. Let's try this. Crew transfer interrupted. Why was the crew transfer interrupted? It worked, though. All right, there's nobody on board. That is a bug in ship manifest for sure. Yes, that's everybody transferred. Okay. Claims that we still need to orbit for 9 days. That sucks. So it remembered the duration, but it didn't store this. All right, well, that's fine. We'll just orbit for 9 days then. First, however, I will fix solar alignment. Okay, now we have good solar alignment. I mean, I really should just complete the contract. Whoa, what's going on here? Yeah, I'm just gonna force complete the contract because they've definitely been in orbit for more than that many days. Why? That was strange. Yeah, why did it flip end for end? That's super weird. Okay. Let's go home. Let's back away. Okay, let's try to not hit Australia this time. Yeah, 60 kilometers is probably fine. Okay. Probably could have done like 70 kilometers, but playing it safe. Okay, let's. Why does this thing have fuel cells? It shouldn't have any fuel cells. Also, here we go. Now we're going to land right smack in the middle of the Indian Ocean. It is very bright. Okay, we're getting data from the desert. Okay, that's a pleasantly low entry angle. Yeah, we totally could have entered with a higher perigee. Trying to be a pretty gentle re-entry given that they've just spent 60 days in space. Oh yeah, also gonna complete that. Contract. 2.6 Gs. Okay, max of 2.7 Gs, that's pretty nice. Pretty good. No longer hypersonic. Subsonic. Okay, decouple the forward heat shield. And in we come. Okay. Here we go. Okay. Also, why do I have recovered SPH as an option? That's weird. Okay, not much in the way of retirement changes. Okay, so this contract is now half complete. We just need to send up the next set of crew. And in particular, we also need to send up a nitrogen tanker. Oh. Wrong one. This is the one we want, I think. Wait a minute. Oh, it's because they're super cheap. I've never bothered to tool them. That's what's going on. Okay, and now we need plenty of tank. Okay. Where's the big old Kerbalism engine? Okay. That's not actually going to be a lot of supplies, is it? No, it is not. All right, I guess we can tool a big service module. Okay, now how long will this last? Okay, so basically 200 person days, if it's that long. So only 40 days for 5 people. All right, so I guess I actually do need some avionics. Love it. Oh, right, of course. Forgot that part. Let's see, how much delta V do we have? Definitely not enough. That is how much delta V we have. All right, that's interesting. That's definitely more interesting. And just for the sake of argument, how long will this all last? Give or take. Oh, blah. Right. One year and 75 days. All right, so that's basically 88 days a person for a five-person mission. So just shy of a 90-day crew rotation. So we need 85 days. Yeah, okay, that's a little over 90 days. What if I did this? All right, so I think this will be what I want to do. Oops. This has the big old fairings. Did I load the wrong thing? Yeah. That's better. Look at what avionics we have tooled. Oops, wrong thing. One by 0.511, 25 tons. Avionics N6, 25 tons, 1 meter by 0.511. So why is it not tooled? Oh, now it should be tooled. Yes. Okay. That's fine. What's the draw rate? 157 watts. So we need about 28k electric charge. All right, so a little less than 2 days. I mean, I guess I could just put solar panels on this. Total volume is 6 kiloliters. Okay. This should fit inside the fairings. Why is it not? That's strange. Oh, 1.4, that's why. I thought this was 1.25. 1.4. Okay. Yeah, that's not enough. Also, why is the available? Why did it lose its contents? That's weird. Okay, that'll do. Okay, then we also need a docking port. And we need to fill a bunch of this tank with nitrogen. Okay. And then lastly, we need some RCS. Okay. There's some RCS. Now, okay, that is an acceptable level of imbalance. Last but not least, we need to carry some lithium hydroxide. Okay, now let's compare again. All right, that's a bunch of lithium hydroxide. Lithium hydroxide is what the scrubbers use, American scrubbers. Okay. And now we don't have enough delta V. Also, these might not. Yeah. That sucks. All right. Okay. Seems fine. The other thing that I really should do is upgrade this engine. It's pretty expensive to upgrade, but it's probably worth it. That 99% reliability. All right, the upgraded version is even more reliable. Yeah, let's try it. Now this gets to get stretched. Okay, so we can do 3 minutes and 35 seconds. Why is the color different? Oh boy. Store color. That looks fine. Only problem is it needs better avionics. Where did that go? Okay. What do I want to call this? I'll call this a mule. I guess there's no real harm in upgrading to the next level of integral tanks. If we're already stretching them, we'll have to rebuy the length anyway. So, yeah, might as well. Okay, that's working better. That is very definitely working better. Somewhere around there is probably where the interstage is. Oh, oops. Okay. Okay. There's this. And let's put another. So 10 tons total, so yeah, let's put another 20 tons on here just to see what our thrust to weight ratio becomes. So I know how much to stretch things. Okay. So we need to make sure we have enough. We have a good enough thrust weight ratio to loft this with a Centaur on top. Oh, there's two of them, that's why. Oh, I actually nailed it. 1.2 is a perfectly fine liftoff thrust weight ratio. Cool. All right. This is fine. Okay, this still has poor tooling, but I don't really want to try to swap it out. Because yeah, I don't really have any good options. Don't want to pay for a new diameter. So we'll use the existing tooling for that stage. Okay, all this is fine. Staging looks almost fine. Okay, what else do we need to tool? These things. That's expensive. That's cheap. And now it's just the avionics. Okay, what kind of reliability are we looking at for this engine? Like a 5% failure chance, probably. Yep. 5% chance of failure. Okay, and we can very easily put a our geostationary stuff on top of this. We can actually carry more. So I'm going to carry more nitrogen. All right, whole lot of nitrogen. Why is that stuck open? Okay. That barely affected our delta V. Here's the other thing we're going to do. That's not enough. That made next to no difference. All right. That's still kind of doubtful. Yeah, okay, sure. I guess we won't tank up on NTO and MMH. You know what, though? Just as some extra insurance, hoping to put some solar panels on this. Let's do that. Yeah, don't particularly want to risk it. So. This is especially relevant because I forgot that, of course, this has an antenna. Which consumes another 20 watts. On top of the 160 watts. So we're at 180 watts, so... There, that'll do. Okay, that hardly makes any difference. These, however, do. All right, and let's optimize the RCS for this configuration. It's actually already pretty good. Okay, that's optimized. Let's put all the propellant back in. And put this back under it. And we're good to go. And we almost certainly have some spare capacity. We'll probably have about 200 meters per second extra, but that's fine. Build a couple of those. Star 20 is basically the next version of the Altair. There's the Antares 3. Where's the Antares 2? Okay. So we need 1976 solids pretty quick. And when that's done, we will be able to launch even better CompSats. Actually going to go ahead and stack this under a CompSat getup and we'll see. Oops, gotta do it in the opposite direction. Okay, so we will use our newest engines. Okay. This is going to screw over our staging badly. Yes, it is. Okay, let's get the service modules from this thing. Comes that payload. Okay, so apparently okay. And it's too heavy for the avionics. What other avionics do I have? Apparently nothing relevant. Oops, that was still using peroxide. Whoops. All right. Okay, seems fine. Okay. So, yeah, we want to be a little under, such that we can fill on RCS. Alright, so how much is this really? 281.36 times 5 is 1400. calculate delta V. Yeah, we have about 300 meters per second extra. If not more. And what that means is that we can probably do something where we do a partial inclination change as part of our perigee kick to establish GTO, and then we go ahead and don't need a full 1837 once in orbit. Really, we just need a larger solid than the Antares. I mean, I guess we could just use two star 37Es. Let's see what happens if we do that. Went somewhere. Well, I'll just do that. That's better. All right. Don't even need to research better solids for it. It does not take 3 minutes and 25 seconds. Come on. Yeah, 42 seconds. Okay. Only downside with doing it this way is it no longer fits the fairing sides. Okay. Okay. $22.98 is what we can get out of this. But we don't actually have enough delta V. So that is a different problem. Let's see. We need another 500 meters per second, give or take. We may not be able to do this. Nope, can't do it. That's a shame. That is the most we can do. And I'm pretty sure it's not good enough. Okay. What? How did that happen? How did that go from 1830 whatever to... Okay. Six kilograms overweight. We need to... We need to shave 6 kilograms somehow. Okay, that'll do. Okay, now what do we get? 13,472 minus 1832 minus 2460 is 9180. Nope, that is insufficient. Is there anything else we can do? These are the best RL10s we can buy. Yes. Okay. We could stretch this more. But pretty sure that's diminishing returns. This might just work, actually. Doubtful, but it might. Especially going to a low parking orbit. Okay. Hopefully this will work. I am slightly doubtful, but we'll see. Might have to actually use some boosters. Let's try it. Oh, the fairings are busted. I don't know why the fairings ended up in the wrong stage again. Okay. Going to be tight. We'll see how it goes. Okay, so pretty much nailed the pitch program by my lights. Yeah, we're coming up a little short. Really annoyingly close, though. Only need about 50 meters per second more. Not sure where we can grab it. And I guess we could go to a super low parking orbit. That's worth trying. Oh, what am I saying? No, we're 100 meters per second short. Oh, that's what's wrong. Right, I didn't trade out the guidance. Okay, that's good. Okay, so we need to scrape together another 100 meters per second somewhere. Okay, so we can afford just under 17 tons. Okay, apparently we're using boosters. Yep, that'll do. Oh, yuck, we're a ton over mass. Okay. Now we fit inside the avionics limits. Try this instead. Here we go. Whoa, that's weird of the tower. Yeah, I could have pitched more aggressively, but it's fine. Yeah, now we actually have about 200 meters per second more delta V than we need. Reasonable so far. Okay, coming up on staging. And yeah, it looks like we have almost exactly 200 meters per second to spare. Yep, 230 odd meters per second extra. Okay, and spin up. Okay, so we have plenty of propellant. Plenty of propellant. What we don't got is avionics. So, let's check out just how much we need. That's stage 6. Yep, 200 kilograms too heavy. $13,699. Alright, that only costs 10 meters per second. That's fine. Alright, what if we go to what's tooled? All right, yeah, we can stick with the tooled version of this. Okay. Good enough. Sure. Let's add it to plans. Nope. Let's try to get something a little better than that. That's fine. All right, the last of the 1070s. Okay. Minutes left to orbit. Insertion. Dawn duty burn. Okay, the last one of these will launch. Okay, a little excess delta V, but it's fine. Right, yet another geostationary COMSAT. Mission complete. And there we go. I'm gonna call it quits. Thanks everyone for watching. I'll catch you next time. Night.